at the end of your life, you're not going to remember the grades that you got. So please don't stress as much as you are. Hi everyone, my name is Rachel. I am a first year osteopathic medical student in the US. And today I'm going to be talking about things that I wish that I had done in undergrad in preparation for medical school and just things that could have helped my application for medical school. If you are a pre-med student, please do not listen to your very negative, you know, those types of pre-med advisors. Please don't listen to them, because if you want to get into medical school, you will. You will get to medicine and end up there if that's what you want and it's for the right reasons and you have that passion for it. And if your pre-med advisor is just extremely pessimistic and not supporting you, then please ignore them, because you can make things happen for yourself. I didn't really experience that much with my pre-med advisors. They never directly doubted me, because I think they kind of knew that I like had that like spark to me where I was not gonna take that crap and I was not gonna let them say that to me. Know deep down that you're gonna be able to make it. Even if you don't have the highest GPA or MCAT score, there's so many other things about yourself that you can offer medical schools, and they would be so lucky and grateful to have you. You're still worthy of becoming a doctor no matter what pre-med advisors say. I wish that I had looked into other opportunities for clinical experience that were also jobs, so you're able to get clinical experience and earn money at the same time. Some other ones are being a phlebotomist, which is like drawing blood from people in the hospital. Also being a pharmacy tech gets you clinical hours, and you're basically working with the pharmacist and like helping sort pills. That's what I do now. And then obviously working as like an EMT. Wish that I had worked as a scribe earlier, or worked as a scribe more. I ended up being an ER scribe for about a summer. It was a great opportunity, but I wish that I had done something that I could have stayed working with for a while, because I wasn't able to continue working with it. Not procrastinating as much in undergrad as I did. There was definitely some times where I crammed the night before an exam and things ended up being fine, and I still ended up doing overall pretty well in the class. In medical school, you certainly cannot do that. You really need to like have solid study strategies and be studying every day at least, or like a little bit every day, and just be working at it for a while. I feel like if I had not crammed and procrastinated like I did in undergrad, then it would have helped make a smoother transition for me in med school to build that foundation of study strategies like that. If I were still in undergrad right now, I would be taking advantage of office hours and TAs much more than I did in undergrad. Office hours are honestly so helpful. Like, it's literally you and the professor, and I feel like people like don't really understand how much it could help you. Also, most of the time if you go to office hours and the TA is running it, they will give you a lot of answers that you need and a lot of help. So if you're an undergrad, do not sleep on office hours and TAs. If I could go back in time, I would completely rework my MCAT study strategy. I will definitely do a video on my MCAT experience and my score one day, but today's not that day. I was taking and studying for the MCAT at the end of my junior year while I was taking like 20 credits, doing ROTC, doing all these clubs, like trying to do everything. I was trying to do content review then, and then do like a 5-week like study, like hardcore practice tests every week. It was crazy. I would have just donated more time to it, tried to not have spread myself so thin, and been more realistic with my MCAT study strategy. In the end, everything ended up fine. I'm in med school. I'm happy. It's all great. I would have taken more advantage of the resources that I had on campus. For example, like the counseling center at my undergrad school, I would have reached out to them earlier when I was feeling super stressed out in undergrad, especially since counseling and therapy can be very expensive. If you can get it for free at your undergrad school or at your medical school or wherever, then I think you should really take advantage of that. Also, just like career advising, you're paying the tuition to go to these schools, so literally find the resources that are there, like reach out and get your resume looked at by people for free. You know, like you're already paying the tuition at your school. Meet with your academic advisors, like get everything on track. Take full advantage of all the things that are offered to you, because that can really put you on track and set you apart from others. When you're a pre-med, when you're an undergrad, when you're on this medical school journey, just please don't stress as much as you are. Something that I wish that I hadn't have done while I was a pre-med was stress as much that I did. Stress and doubt myself. I feel like it's so easy to doubt yourself because, you know, we've got these pre-med advisors that are doubting us, and there's all of these socioeconomic barriers to getting into medical school, and just the pure financial burden that it is to even be preparing for it, applying for it, getting into it, going to it. It's insane. It's absolutely insane. But please don't doubt yourself. Honestly, there's not that much of a difference between an A and an A minus, between an A minus and a B plus. And I understand that when you're in the moment and you're just trying to do well in your pre-med classes, that's all you're thinking about. But please know that you're not gonna remember the grades that are on your transcripts in college. Maybe you're trying to get into Harvard Medical School and that ain't me, like that couldn't be me. But at the end of your life, you're not gonna remember the grades that you got. So please don't stress as much as you are, and please stop doubting yourself. And then finally, something that I wish that I had known in undergrad is that everything is going to work out in the end. So like I said, please stop doubting yourself. Just know that it's going to work out. If you're passionate about this path and this is what you want to do with your life, it's going to work out for you and everything is going to be okay. If you're a pre-med watching this, please take a deep breath, have a sip of water, and just take care of yourself because it's going to be okay. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really appreciate it if you're here right now still. And if you watch this video, please subscribe if you aren't subscribed. And I hope that you have an amazing day.